What's going on? It's Big Rome. I'm back. Now, today what we're going to do is we're going to learn how to do a T-bone steak. So let's go ahead and show you what seasonings I'll be using today. So first things first, I'm going to go ahead and use the Worcestershire sauce. And the other thing I'm going to be using is the Suckle Busters, 1836. Oh yeah, I'm ready for this. So let's get started. All right. So we got the T-bone steak here. We're ready to go ahead and get this marinated. So the first thing I'm gonna go ahead and use, which I mentioned earlier, is the Worcestershire sauce. And then from there, we're gonna use the Suckle Busters 1836. So let's go ahead and get this started. Doesn't take long to go ahead and add some of that Worcestershire sauce. Go ahead and blend this in real quick. Turn this around, add some more Worcestershire sauce. Oh yeah. Now what we're gonna go ahead and do is we're gonna go ahead and add the 1836 Suckle Busters right here. So this is gonna be pretty awesome right here to go ahead and try this out. Let's go ahead and make that happen. Oh yeah, it's blending in well. Go ahead and pat it down a little bit. And I can see a lot of coarse pepper in there. It's really, really nice texture to it here. So let's go ahead and do the other side. I'm doing it nice and thick because as you can see, it's a pretty good sized steak here, about a quarter inch here. So definitely I wanna get all those flavors in and make sure all those flavors get grilled, and whew, it's gonna be so good. So I wanna go ahead and show you, have you check it out, how it looks. Man, it's looking so good. Man, I haven't even ate it yet, and check that out. It's real beautiful right there. So definitely, let's go ahead and turn on the grill, and let's get started. All right, so before we start cooking these steaks, what we need to do is we actually need to get the charcoal ready, right, Jasmine? Mm-hmm. All right, so what is it that we're gonna do first?
We're going to put these in a mountain, but my dad already put this on.
Okay, so let's go ahead and do that now. All right, check you out. Gotta make that mountain look good. Jazz is doing good so far. Let's do this. And it doesn't take long to do. All you gotta do is make a little mountain to it. This is not actually her first time. I've taught her the first time about what, a month? 2 months ago?
Yeah, 2 months.
2 months ago, right?
Yeah.
So I taught her how to do the little mountain in case you don't have a small chimney. So that's exactly what she's doing. She's making sure that all those charcoal briquettes are in a mountain type of look here. So you want to put some there for sure there on top. Yeah, because that's going to start. That's what's going to make it start really good. Right on top, right onto the top. Yeah, all the way to the top. Yeah, there you go. So it looks pretty good. So let's go ahead and get this started. So we're going to turn this on. As you can see. And once it starts going, it's going to start turning on. So Jasmine, thank you very much for your help. And I know that when it comes to seeing what I'm going to do next, I know you'll be watching, right? All right, what do you got to say now?
Little Jazz out.
All right. All right, so now the kettle, little 14-inch, is ready to go ahead and put that steak. So let me go ahead and show you how the steak looks like first before I put it inside the kettle grill. Check it out. Oh, man. Check that out. Look at the color. It's looking real good right there. So let's go ahead. I'm going to do it hot and fast, 5 minutes on each side. And let's go ahead and start on the first side. One T-bone steak, ready to go. Wow.
Love the sizzle, baby. Love the sizzle. Let's take a look real quick. Good right there. All right, let's go ahead and close this down and let it sizzle a little more, and we'll get some results. 5 minutes each side, okay? Internal temp, you want it at 165 for medium rare. All right, so the 5 minutes are up. Let's go ahead and turn this over. Oh yeah. Oh yeah, that's looking good. Check that out. All right, let's go ahead and leave it for 5 more minutes on that side, and we'll go ahead and cut it up and try it out and see how it comes or how it tastes. All right, here we go. Now the 5 minutes are up on the other side. Now it's time for me to go ahead and take that T-bone steak out. I'm gonna put it back into the aluminum foil, and then I'm gonna let it sit there for about 15 to 20 minutes, just so all the juices are put all together. So check it out. Oh man, check that out. Get the juices on that. Woo-wee. That's some good stuff right there. Let's go ahead and put that in the aluminum foil. I'm gonna wrap it up and let it set and sit for a little bit, 15, 20 minutes. And then from there, you know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna taste it. Oh yeah. All right, so I got Jazz here to go ahead and try out this steak. So I'm gonna sit down with you, and we're gonna go ahead and cut it up, right? So let's check it out. It looks good, huh? Yeah. So, smells good? Nice, nice. So, I use the Sucker Busters 1836 on this. And I'll tell you something. I can smell it from right here. It smells great. But the thing about it is, we got to taste it. But I decided to bring my daughter so she can try it out too. So, why not? So, check it out. Go ahead and cut this up. Oh yeah. There we go. And actually, the way I'm looking at it right now is a little bit of medium well, but it's perfect. It's still perfect. There's still juices in here. It's looking great. But the only way to find out how it tastes is I gotta get my daughter to try it out and see what she thinks. And then I'll go ahead and try it out. There you go. And I'm gonna go ahead and try it out too. How is it?
Good.
Is it real good? What flavors do you taste?
I taste spiciness.
Yeah, so it's the pepper, you got the salt. So it's a lot of good juices, but either way, I mean, it's good. So all I know is, good job, Sucker Busters, 1836. Yeah. You want another piece? Okay, so my daughter wants another piece, so that kind of tells you something that is pretty good. So all I gotta say now is big Rome out and
no.
All right.